Lavender. I asked LinkedIn which sales tools I should be checking out, and an overwhelming number of people told me to take a look at Lavender. Lavender is an email assistant that provides real-time coaching to salespeople and promises to help them write better sales emails faster. I've been following one of their co-founder, Will Allred, on LinkedIn. Great follow, by the way. He posts really actionable tips on how to make your emails more effective. Now, emails have historically been my favorite method and also most effective method of prospecting. Anything to avoid making cold calls, am I right? So if this is a tool that can help make improvements there, then I have no doubt that this would make me a better salesperson. Before I jump in and start using the tool though, I wanted to talk to someone who is already using the tool to get some idea of how they're getting value from using it.
In a nutshell, Lavender is like real life, like coaching on your emails. It's helped show me the difference between what a marketing email might look like and what a sales email would look like. And so having that real-time coaching has really change the way that I think about writing emails and sequences and how I speak to people as well. It literally says start writing and we'll work with you on this email as you're typing.
I'm gonna go download that extension now. I'm gonna give it a go. I'll let you know when the video is up and I'll tag you in it, all right?
Yeah, for sure.
Let's go check it out for ourselves. I almost forgot. I wanna make sure that I'm experiencing lavender with all of my senses, which is why I pulled out the scented candle. So hopping onto the website, the first thing I'm greeted by is this beautiful wizard, who is, of course, holding a stick of lavender. I'm starting to notice the theme here. Give it a quick scroll and I get this awesome animation, and the first thing I'm told to do is install the extension. There's a mobile app as well, you can use it in the mobile, that's actually really good to know. Go ahead and install. Let's get started. Okay, so it's giving me a bit of a tutorial. Add a profile picture. Got my little avatar in there. Yeah, sales tech talks. I've currently got F because I haven't used this yet. A formality analysis, am I a casual person or am I formal, gender, and then we've got word count, clarity level, question count, subject length. So those are obviously the things I'm being scored on, and then there's a sentiment thing here. I hope my emails don't come across angry, but we will see. Open up my Gmail, so I'm going to do just that. So I've just written out a quick email to Armand here to invite him to be interviewed for one of our other shows. First of all, I did the subject line, your TV career, sales feed. Oh, issues detected already. Armand. As Tyler might have mentioned, that's my boss, Tyler Assad, might have told you, we're working on a couple of high production shows here at SalesFeed, one of which, Sales Stuff Explained, is an explainer-style documentary on various sales topics. One of the upcoming episodes will be focusing on running a great demo, and after listening to you speak on the topic a few times, I think you'd make a great SME for an interview. Could be a chance to kick off a TV career. Interested in getting involved. I want to know what Lavender thinks of this and to give me some feedback. So start my email. Okay, it's a bit late for that. GIFs. Okay, all right. So this is a view on the what it would look like on a mobile device. And I can actually make edits on that as well. That's mad because look, if you compare what I've written on the screen, 4 lines of text to the mobile, which is like 11 lines of text, you don't think about this. Most emails get sent on desktop but read on mobile. And this is like 2 fat paragraphs of text right here. All right, well, I'm gonna work on the email a little bit and come back to that afterwards. But the other thing is the email assistant. So I've got 87. That's pretty good. So it's good in formality, question counts, I versus you. Your IU ratio is 2 to 4. The ideal ratio is 1 to 2. Email length. Your email is 79 words. Short and concise emails have the best chance of getting a reply. No spam detected. What kind of words are in spam, I wonder? Bitcoin. It's told me that it's taken me 3 minutes to write this email and that it's gonna take 21 seconds to read. That's actually really crazy. You never think about how long your emails take to read because you'd need to pull out a timer on your phone, read out loud, and then go back to the email. I've never thought about that, not once. Okay, let's see what needs work. We've got long words. Long and uncommon words make it harder for your recipient to quickly read and understand your message. So it's highlighted the 2 words that are long, documentary and interested. Is interested a long word? Not sure about that. Why don't we try and shorten this down? to Doc. I like the word interested. I think it's a really good call to action in emails, but maybe I'm wrong. Come at me, Lavender. I mean, that's one thing. If you're gonna suggest that my words are too long, it'd be really, really cool if there was a better recommendation given to you, like curious. Okay, so next one, it says I've got long sentences. That's fair, because on the mobile device, these looked super long. So maybe there's a way I could break these up quickly. Hang on a second. What is this button gonna do? Tyler might have told you we're working on a couple of high production shows here at SalesFeed. Oh! That just rewrote the sentence for me. That's... Okay, I'm impressed. I'm really impressed. Let's do it again. This is so fun. Suggest a concise sentence. The upcoming photo episode will focus on how to run a demo. I'm actually in awe right now. Why don't we keep going? Subject length too long. How long should it be? 2 to 5 words. Well, that's 5 words. I mean, is that better? I'm second guessing everything I've ever known about writing an email. Too complex. What's this? Your email is written at a 7th grade reading level. That's a bit offensive. Simpler emails tend to get more replies. Wait, it's telling me to be more simple? Okay. So I need to simplify this somehow. What's hedge words? Ah, Tyler might have told you that we're working on a couple. Few. Okay, so it's trying to tell me to be more like to the point. Tyler must have. High production shows. Okay, all right. We just made the sentence shorter again. Here at SalesFeed. Let's get rid of the word various. We're just getting rid of words now. We're just axing them. Just killing words. This is fantastic. I don't know if my score has improved at all. Oh, we got an A. So any word that doesn't add value to the email, you should get rid of. Let's get rid of some more words. Let's do it. Yes, Lavender. Shows at SalesFeed. That is so much more to the point. Like, it's come a long way. I'm trying to think about this. Have I gone too far? Is the point of the email still here? Gosh, look at my writing time. It's just gone. Been sat here overthinking the email. I'm not getting the email out. Is 95 good enough? No, we can do better. I think I'm being a bit pedantic, but you know what? I want a perfect score. I'm competitive as heck. I'm a salesperson. It's what we do, okay? I'm not even sure anymore. I've been staring at this for so long that maybe I'm overthinking it. And maybe that's a problem, all right? Maybe not. Maybe I should have been happy when it said 90. Maybe, I don't know. One thing I want to do before I send this off to Armand is check how this email now looks on mobile compared to how it looked at the start. And I mean, straight away, the difference is huge. There is so much more white space on this screen now. I'm gonna shoot that off and I will let you know if Armand responds. I wanted to show you the dashboard. It's updated now. My sentiment is unsure, friendly, happy, and confident, which is all the things that I am. Gives me a score trending over time. So it shows me if I'm getting better or worse as time goes on. And for a manager, I have to think if you had this view into each of your team members' emails, then there'll be a ton of coaching opportunity here as well. There's also an analytics tab, which tells me pretty much the same thing in a different kind of analysis. Okay, here's what I wanted to get to. The pricing. There is actually a free plan, includes 10 emails a month. So that's not that many, especially for a salesperson. That said, it does say here that if you're a student or a job seeker, you can use it for free, which is pretty darn cool and does confirm my suspicion that this could be used for more than just sales emails if a job seeker is using it, for example. And it's $19 a month. That doesn't seem like a lot of money to me. I could probably stick that on my credit card and be quite happy with just not expensing that. Obviously, I want my company to pay for as many tools as possible. If I think this is something that's gonna help me do my job better, yeah, I'd get $19 out. This is more than $19 value for sure. So what are my thoughts? I think it's kind of obvious that I am impressed. I would describe this as game-changing because if you look at this before and this after of that email that I just wrote to Armand, it's night and day. Now, what do I have to say that's a bit maybe not so positive? I think there is a chance that by having this tool that you are tricked into some analysis paralysis. You need to balance between trying to hit perfect and making a mediocre email a good email. It doesn't need to be perfect every time. And I think that comes with a little bit of using the tool more often as well. And I definitively give Lavender 5 out of 5 stars. honestly, they've built such a fantastic tool here. It's unlike anything I've even seen. I don't know how long it's been around for, but I wish I'd have known about it sooner. I will continue to use it for the rest of the trial, and I will buy it afterwards as well. I start at the top. I can only go down from here. Have a good one. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time on Sales Tech Talks. Hey there, folks. Hope you enjoyed that first episode of Sales Tech Talks. If you did, then please do consider liking and subscribing and commenting to let me know which tool I should check out next time.